It has been an enigma so long that it was an ancient mystery even to the Aztec Indians, who were fascinated by its ruins 700 years ago. Scholars call it by the name ascribed to it by the Aztecs, Teotihuacan, the abode of the gods.
The Teotihuacanos were really the mystery people of ancient Mexico, because although they built the largest single city and one of the largest civilizations of ancient America, we don't know who they were. We don't know what language they spoke. We don't know which ethnic group they were.
One of the most intriguing revelations is that it was laid out according to a set of alignments that linked it to the movements of the stars relative to the surrounding mountains. Looming majestically over Teotihuacan is the city's mesmerizing focal point, the Pyramid of the Sun. 20 stories tall, measuring more than 700 feet to a side at its base, it rivals the Great Pyramid of Giza in Egypt. But unlike that structure, its principal function was not as a tomb for a king. Instead, the Pyramid of the Sun may have been a monument marking Teotihuacan's most sacred spot. Hidden directly beneath it lies a mysterious cave. It extends 330 feet from its mouth near the base of the pyramid to a point beneath its center. Scholars think this cavernous expanse may have been where Teotihuacanos believed the world was created.
We know for later mythologies of central Mexico and even the American Southwest that caves are often considered to be the place of origin, that humans were born out of a cave. Basically, the earth is a great womb. The cave under the Pyramid of the Sun may have been the cave.
Some scholars believe the Teotihuacanos were driven to create a utopia in order to find favor with their gods. Scholars point to the Teotihuacanos' art as evidence of this belief.
They seem to be really emphasizing the importance of the group over the individual, the importance of balance, the importance of community. And I think that's one of the major strengths of this site, was they had sort of a cult of the warrior, a cult of the soldier, that you would die for the common benefit of the group.
Instead of rulers, we have representations of identical profile figures looking very much like a committee. So we have a representation at Teotihuacan of a rulership that kept a very low profile and that made very sure that not a single individual was elevated above the rest.
In other ancient cultures, the literary record often revolved around the exploits of its rulers. Almost inconceivably, this highly advanced culture left behind no evidence of a written language.
Religion has to have been the cement that kept Teotihuacan together. And we know this not only from the enormous size of the major temples, but also from the fact that religious activity was associated with everybody at every level.
Unlike other religions in which life is looked upon as a gift from a supreme being, they believed that life was theirs simply because they forcefully took it from the gods. For the Teotihuacanos, the most effective method of appeasing their gods may have been to return to them a measure of the human life that was originally taken from them. So the death of a select few humans may have ensured life for the rest of the people. But in the 8th century, this utopian paradise mysteriously crumbled. Apparently, a fateful choice was made. Nature would be sacrificed so their great city could live.
Teotihuacan, just to be built, is causing an incredible environmental desecration up in central Mexico. One of the things you need in order to make all those fabulous paintings and to make those huge buildings is a lot of mortar. And the way you get mortar is that you burn limestone. And the way you burn limestone is you cut down whole forests.
Some scholars believe that the desecration of the environment might have enraged not only the gods, but the city's inhabitants, spurring rebellion. A gleaming utopia born 2,000 years ago passed into legend. Yet the ruins remain silent and unyielding, forever concealing the mysteries of the great civilization and their utopia that once thrived here.